Well, handwritten cards and letters are becoming a thing of the past, as you know, but one Bay Area businesswoman has found a way to bring the practice into the future.
Good. Well, KPIX 5's Elizabeth Cook spoke with the owner of Minted, where local artists are bringing back a lost art.
When was the last time you got a letter or a card or even an invitation in the mail? If you're like many people, it may be difficult to remember. Written correspondence is going digital, but one Silicon Valley veteran is turning the tables on that trend and doubling down on paper by taking an old-school business model and giving it a high-tech twist.
I think there are certain things that I think will stick around. There are certain things like art in your walls or art on your walls, home goods that I think aren't going to go away. Some forms of paper won't go away. And people do like to live their lives, I think, digitally and physically, and those designs, that style that you're projecting, your personal style, needs to live across the two.
Maryam Nafisi started Minted 9 years ago.
I thought that stationery needed an uplift in terms of design and needed fresher and more interesting things, and that's how it really got started.
The goal, to give unknown artists and designers a platform to show off their work and make a little money. Minted is an online marketplace for custom stationery, artwork, and home decor. The cards, pillows, and artwork are designed by everyday people who enter into various Minted design competitions for a chance to sell their item on the website.
What I found, of course, was that there was just a world of discovery, you know, happened later, that there were many creative people hidden from view across the whole world, that they were the ones entering our competitions, not stationery designers per se, but people who were just creatives were entering. We could put them at the front of the store.
Creators like Lori Rodile of San Francisco.
I discovered Minted by just perusing the web and looking for great card ideas and inspiration.
Lori admits she put painting on the back burner after having children.
On the art side, it's got me more interested in doing art on a day-to-day basis, so that's really been exciting for me.
Lori's design was one of the winners of the West Elm Challenge, one of the contests where Minted partnered with major retailers, including Pottery Barn Kids.
It was great. That really kind of pushed me to try some new things, and it was great to see what other people were entering and how very different everybody's take on the challenge was.
Unlike many commission-based businesses, Minted artists get the cash prize from the competition and an upfront percentage of the sales profits from their design. Minted takes care of the printing and distribution of the products.
And what we've found is that we've created a real meritocracy where anyone can break into product design. They don't have to have a specific education, connections, capital. They can actually break in just by winning a competition, and we'll do the rest for them. We'll help them get to market. And that's unlocked a huge amount of creative talent that was locked away from us as buyers, as consumers. We could never have access to those people. It was really hard for anyone to believe, even me, that thousands of people would enter our competitions. That was not ultimately, it was not immediately believable. But I always wanted to stick with that as the root, because I felt that that was the thing that really differentiated us. These are all local artists.
She says it wasn't always easy convincing investors, most of them men, that Minted was worth the financial risk.
Style businesses, design, fashion, trying to bridge the gap for male investors to understand that there is a market opportunity is one of the key challenges. They said women don't buy online. And my partner and I looked at each other and said, well, that's because you're not selling things that women want to buy online.
In 1998, before she was even 30, Maryam started Eve.com, a website that sold high-end cosmetics online. Now remember, this was years before Sephora became popular. It was eventually bought by a bigger company and dubbed just another victim of the tech bubble. But Maryam doesn't see it that way.
We sold it successfully for about $100 million in cash to Louis Vuitton Moët Hennessy that had just started Sephora in the U.S.
While the world may be going more digital, Maryam believes Minted is proof some things will never change. A card or an invitation feels more personal when you can hold it in your hand. And a piece of art hanging in your home means more when you know something about the artist.
When I started Minted, more people told me that paper couldn't be sold online. You know, so every time I've tried to start something, I'm used to now just getting that overall, you know, this is not going to work. But that's what happens when you're an entrepreneur. You're going to get a lot of people telling you this is not going to work.
Minted artists take home anywhere from $100 to $10,000 in cash prizes. The commissions range from 6% to 10% of each purchase, depending on the product category.
Oh, there's nothing like a handwritten letter. I've saved all of my grandmother's.